We've come to know the aswang as one of the most feared mythological creatures in the Philippines. By day, it takes on a human form, only to shapeshift into an ugly monster with wings at night.
The new film Vampiria has a new take on this creature while touching on important topics our society faces. Take a look.
Mommy. Oh my gosh. With us is the man responsible for bringing that creature to our side of the world, Matthew Abaya, director and writer of Vampiria. And with him is Arlene Boado, the leader of the Vampire Hunters.
Hello, Arlene. Hello, Matthew.
Welcome to Adomination, you guys.
Thank you.
Exciting stuff. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's start it out, Matthew. We understand that Vampiria initially started from a movie that you did years ago called Vampinay. Mm-hmm. So once again, same kind of sort of vampire concept here. So how did you conceive this idea? And why vampires, dude? Why?
You know, I mean, vampires are kind of like us. Like, it's like the modern mythology. Like, you know, like people used to go to like Greek gods to kind of like project a lot of their human desires on. I think nowadays people like creatures like that, whether it be superheroes or anti-heroes. I chose vampires because, you know, they are the epitome of like the anti-hero and a lot of the real desires that we really want.
And let's face it, they are probably the most interesting of these horror creatures.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you know, yeah, they're complex.
Immortal. Mm-hmm.
They're not like, you know, just like gross zombies. Like,
yeah.
Smelly.
Yeah, yeah, smelly zombies, yeah. Right? But okay, so there's a vampire, there's like sexy Twilight vampire, and then there's like super scary, horrible, you know, action movie vampires. And then there's this, which actually kind of, to me, looks like a manananggal. So how did you develop this idea of a vampire for this film?
Well, you know, when I called it an aswang, I always interpreted like a manananggal to be a type of aswang or a type of vampire.
Oh, it's like subspecies.
A subspecies.
Yeah.
I based it on like Maximo Ramos's books, if you're familiar with his stuff. He's really kind of like a real laureate on that particular topic.
Google time.
Okay. Yes, exactly. So, you know, when I actually wanted to make a movie about this creature, actually, when I was in Manila with my grandmother, and we're watching, like, I don't know, Shake, Rattle, and Roll or something.
Oh my God, I love
you guys remember those movies?
Yeah. I'm like, yes, or
and classic.
It's like, oh, Tianlak, that's some creepy stuff right there. Maybe the next movie, okay?
Awesome. So, Arlene, you play one of the lead roles, right? You're not a vampire. You're one of the vampire hunters.
I am the leader of the vampire
hunters. You are the leader of the vampire.
One of the Bidas.
Yes.
So, tell me about this role, because I feel like, you know, on the outside, it could be simplistic, right? Like, oh, I'm on a mission to hunt vampires. Mm-hmm. Like, how did you make this role interesting and relatable to people?
I just really had to tap into...
the desire to want to kill?
Which exists in every woman.
Yeah, I guess so, yeah. I mean, or actually just the adverse of her wanting to kill somebody. She has like such passion for getting, she had one main agenda, and that's just to seek and destroy these undead, these vampires.
Right.
And also, but her day job, she was a TV personality.
Oh.
And so.
Wait a second.
Yeah, I knew it.
And there was like a little parallel there where, you know, her agenda there was she didn't want, how she did not want any of the undeads, she didn't want any of the foreigners. That was her agenda as a personality. So I just had to.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then there's a kind of like a love-hate relationship also, right? Without giving too much of the movie away, there's a love-hate relationship between the people who hunt the vampires and the vampires themselves. Mm-hmm. So anyone want to talk about that? Yeah.
Well, the line between what is like a good guy and a bad guy is really blurred in this one.
I like that.
Yeah.
But
like, and that's so true in life, right? Mm-hmm.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And I know some people would actually ask me, who is the main character of this story? And I was like, well, you're going to have to watch it really to find out.
So let's talk about like the filmmaking side of it, or more importantly, like how this is going to get distributed and how we're going to get people to watch it. Mm-hmm. Where are you guys showing it? And kind of what's the hope for the movie? Like, do you want Oscar winning? Yeah, do you want to make it the rounds of Cannes?
Why not?
Oh my gosh, you know, when it comes to Oscars, I mean, I have not known many horror films to win Oscar awards.
But hey.
Yeah. It could happen.
It could happen, but I think it's like one of the, you know, horror is like it's one of those really awesome genres because it's actually paved a lot of ways for like minorities. And I wanted to take a minority perspective on this. I mean, as a Filipino American, I felt like we have a chance to really just kind of reach like a really, really broad audience with this kind of movie.
Yeah, show your roots.
Exactly.
So where is it showing now, or where is it going to be showing where our nation can watch it?
Oh, yes. We're going to be playing it at the Los Angeles Asian Pacific Film Festival. That's going to be at the Downtown Independent, and it's a midnight screening.
Ooh.
Actually, 11:30, but we're going to call it midnight.
Vampiraya, mga ka-nation. You know, check it out.
Thank you.